If you've had the good luck of standing in Times Square, then you surely know why it is known as the City of Skyscrapers. Now, if you're anything like me who likes to wonder quite a lot on his mind, the question, how long do those skyscrapers actually last, must have crossed your mind too. Well, the question isn't that easy to answer. There are quite some skyscrapers that are still standing after decades, even centuries, like the Temple Court Building. Let's dive a bit deep into the world of skyscrapers to find out a broader answer. First, let's just show a proper appreciation for the architectural knowledge of the Egyptian people, who were responsible for monuments like the Great Pyramid of Giza. The Great Pyramid of Giza has stood at a height of around 460 feet for 4,500 years. It was completed in 2540 BC and is unrivaled with superior materials, engineering, and design to any built before or since. Ancient Greek tourists would travel thousands of miles to gawk at its towering limestone steps. But these days, we're ripping down tall structures without even having so much thought. It raises the question of how we could reimagine tower design so that it lasts centuries rather than decades. What goes up, well, must come down. And humanity has put up and pulled down some pretty big buildings since the emergence of the modern skyscraper around 140 years ago. The tallest of these was the 41-story Singer Building in New York City at a height of 187 meters tall, which was pulled down in 1968 after just 70 years. Well, the blame can be put on the lack of advancement in construction technology and materials. This can also back up why the famous Empire State Building in New York, which was built in 1931, after around 35 years from the Singer Building, still standing tall, waiting to touch the milestone of a century just in 9 years. So following that argument, what do you think? How long will the current tallest building in the world last? Yes, we're talking about the Burj Khalifa, standing at twice the height of the Empire State Building. At least a couple of decades, and if the people from 45,000 years ago could build something to last this long, we have an upper hand on them with the technology, so we can easily give some competition, right? Well, as said earlier, the answer isn't that easy. When it comes to skyscrapers, there comes a lot of factors that determine their lifespan. First is the height itself. The higher up you go, the faster the wind gets to stop skyscrapers from falling over, and those at the top from getting seasick. They are designed with irregular shapes, which disrupt the wind and stop it from becoming organized. It may look like an architectural flourish, but the distinctive jagged profiles of the Burj are more for safety than artistry. Even a hurricane wouldn't push it over. Then there's the lightning. With up to a billion volts of electricity in a single bolt, skyscrapers are at risk of being hit by a force with more power than a nuclear reactor. Luckily, there's a workaround. During construction, the building's steel skin is wired together. Every steel bar, every window frame, right the way down to the foundation. It works like a giant Faraday cage, a protective enclosure similar to the wire mesh on microwave ovens, which keeps its contents safe by restricting electricity to the outside. Lastly, there's an earthquake. In case of an earthquake, the skyscrapers are a greater risk because of their height from the ground, which makes them more unstable than the other buildings. But with modern technology, skyscrapers are extremely sturdy. Even in an earthquake, they have a higher chance of standing it with the help of simple physics, resonance. Stating the importance of a longer lifespan of a skyscraper, an expert had this to share. 1996, the world completed 10 buildings 200 meters or higher. 2017, that number was 144. Cities are becoming megacities, with many tall buildings clustered together. If we're not planning these to have century-long lifespans, well, we're going to have a problem in 20 years. Now, when it comes to comparison with the Pyramid of Giza, will today's skyscrapers last that long? Well, here's what another expert said. Concrete structures will last longer since rust sets in long before the concrete begins to crumble. But a pyramid expert suggests that it's less likely to happen. I very much doubt it. They're functional structures for sure, but they will last only as long as there is a need for that function. And then, they'll simply be abandoned, he says. What are your thoughts on this? Let us know in the comments. I'll see you another time in another video. Stay in the loop.